Hello and welcome to O Levels. Hello and welcome to O Levels Virtual School. This is IGCSE Biology 0610, and I am your teacher, Dr. Hamna. In this video, we will be starting Chapter 2, Cells or the Organization of Life. Note that in this chapter, we will not be covering the entire chapter in full detail, but this video will surely give you a rundown of all of the topics included in this chapter. So the first topic we will be studying is the animal and plant cells. So here are two diagrams of the animal and plant cell. Just by looking at these diagrams, you can see that the plant cell over here has a specific shape. You can see that it is kind of like a square. And the animal cell does not. It is roundish and does not have a specific shape. This is the first detail that you can notice when you look at these two diagrams. The plant cell has this specific shape because it has a cell wall. The cellulose cell wall, this is specific to the plant cell. It's not present in the animal cell. Now, we've covered the cell wall. You can see that there are structures within the cells as well. You can see in the plant cell and the animal cell. The structures that are contained inside the cell are called organelles. We will study in more detail about all of these organelles and their functions as well. But just looking at these diagrams, you can see that the plant cell and the animal cell, they both have like an outer layer and the structures within them. So the outer layers are their membranes. Plant cell has two layers. So first, it has a cell wall and then a cell membrane, whereas the animal cell just has the cell membrane covering or supporting it or protecting it. Then the structures that are inside both of these cells, there is a cytoplasm, which is the liquid present in both of these cells. All of the organelles are suspended within this cytoplasm. And then you have the nucleus, the mitochondria, the vacuole, chloroplast. These are the rest of the organelles that are present. The labels which are labeled green over here are specific to the plant cell, which means that they are not present in the animal cells, which is the cell wall. The cell wall is not present in the animal cell. The chloroplast is not present in the animal cell, and the permanent vacuole, which is also not present in the animal cell. Okay. Moving further, let's study the cell organelles and their function. Here is another diagram. This is a little advanced. This diagram has a little more structures. You can see more organelles. You can see the organelles in more detail in this diagram. So, but you can still see that the plant cell has a specific shape. The animal cell does not. You can identify it by that this is a plant cell, this is not. In the plant cell, you know that there is a large vacuole in the middle. This vacuole is there. And you have the cell wall, cell membrane, the vacuole, nucleus is present in both of these cells, which is identifiable. There is cytoplasm, which contains all of the organelles. Now, this structure over here, this rod structure with squiggles in the middle, is the mitochondria or the mitochondrion. A singular is the mitochondrion, and the multiples you call mitochondria. These mitochondria are a very important organelle of both of these cells. You can identify them by seeing that whichever structure is a rod-like structure with a squiggle in the middle, that is the mitochondria. Now, here is another structure. You can see these tiny dots. These tiny dots, these are ribosomes. We will study what their function is as well. You can see these ribosomes might either be suspended in the cytoplasm or they could be near the nucleus and attached to another cell organelle that we will study later on. Here I have included this chart. This has all of the cell organelles, their structure and their functions. So let's start with cell wall. You can see that it is shaded green, so it's present only in plant cells. So cell wall, specific to only plants. The structure is that it is a rigid layer made up of cellulose in plant cells, and its function is that it provides support and protection to the cell and also gives it the shape. Okay, so we've seen it in the diagram that the shape of the plant cell is very structured and it has a specific shape that is due to the presence of its cell wall. Now, the second organelle we have is the cell membrane. Cell membrane is present in both plant and animal cells. It is a thin layer of protein and fat, which is outside the cell. And it protects the cell, and the major function of the cell membrane is that it controls what goes in and out of the cell, meaning that it is partially permeable. Cell membrane is said to be partially permeable. Permeable means that it gives permission to certain substances to go in and certain to go out and certain to not go in and not go out. So that's how it controls what goes in and out of the cell. Cytoplasm, present in both of the cells, is the jelly-like substance, which is 70% of water because it's a liquid, and it holds the cell organelles in place. All of the cell organelles are suspended in the cytoplasm. Now we have vacuoles. Now, I've written here both, but I've shaded it green. So the vacuoles are a special organelle. So they're present in both of the cells, but in plant cell, because it's shaded green, you can see that in plant cell, they have a large vacuole. All plant cells have a large vacuole. Vacuoles are basically an empty space. So there is space in the cell surrounded by a membrane containing a solution. And there are a empty space. So that space acts as a storage area. So all vacuoles act as a storage area for the cells. They store food or any waste. So in plant cell, they contain the cell sap. And in animal cell, they contain the water and food. Now, vacuoles are sometimes not labeled in animal cells. Why is that? Because animal cells don't usually have a large vacuole in them. They usually have very, very small vacuoles, and only some of the animal cells have these vacuoles. These vacuoles are so small in animal cells that sometimes they're not even called vacuoles, they're called vesicles. But they have the similar function as vacuoles. Vesicles and vacuoles both have the same function. They act as storage areas for the cells. So they are present in both of the cells. But if you need to just write which cell organelles are only present in plant, you can write a permanent large vacuole, which is only present in the plant cell, not the animal cell. Now, next we have chloroplast. Now, chloroplast is also specific to the plant cell. They are large green structures. They contain the green pigment, which is chlorophyll. And chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis, the process by which plants get their energy. And photosynthesis needs chlorophyll because this chlorophyll is responsible for absorbing the sunlight from the sun. So that is why we need this chloroplast. The plants need this chloroplast. They are present only in plants. The next organelle we have is the nucleus, arguably the most important organelle. This is present in both of the cells. It's a large oval structure and it contains the genetic information. This genetic information helps the cell to make the right sort of proteins. And this genetic information is kept on chromosomes, which are made up of DNA. If we don't want to write all of this detail, you can just write that the nucleus contains the genetic information of the cell. Next, we have the mitochondria. Now, mitochondria is present in both of these cells. They are rod-shaped structures. I told you before in the diagram, I showed you that they are rod-shaped structures with a squiggle in the middle. Mitochondria are the powerhouses of the cell. They are powerhouses because they release energy. They give the cells energy, and we get this energy from either food or respiration or oxygen by respiration. So the food we eat and the oxygen that we respire, it gets to our cells and it gets to the mitochondria, and mitochondria converts that energy so that that energy could be used by the rest of the cell. So that is why it is the powerhouse of the cell. Next, we have ribosomes. Ribosomes are present in both of the cells, plant and animal cells. They are tiny bodies. They are attached to rough endoplasmic reticulum, or they also might just be suspended in the cytoplasm on their own. They might either be attached to the rough ER or just be suspended in the cytoplasm. Now, the ER, endoplasmic reticulum, is a network of membranes that are also present in the cell. They are another organelle that are present. But here we're talking about ribosomes, which are the important organelles. Ribosomes are important because they synthesize proteins. They join amino acids because amino acids are the building blocks of proteins. That is how proteins are formed. They are formed by amino acids, and these amino acids are joined by ribosomes. All right, these were the cell organelles, their structure and their functions. Now, here is a very detailed diagram of the plant cell and the animal cell. Still, you can see in this diagram that the plant cell has a structure. It's a hexagonal structure over here, but it has a structure, whereas the animal cell is like circular or oval and does not have a specific shape. Now, here you can see the rod-shaped organelle with squiggle in the middle. This is the mitochondria. You can see there is a large vacuole in the plant cell. There are the green structures, which are the chloroplast. There's a cell wall also. There's a large nucleus in both of these cells. There are large nucleus, there are mitochondria in both of these cells. Here you can see the vacuole, a small vacuole that is present in the animal cell. Here, this structure over here that you see surrounding the nucleus, this structure is the ER, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now, endoplasmic reticulum is of two types. It's either rough or it's either smooth. How is it rough or smooth? If there are ribosomes attached to the ER, then that ER is rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so this ER that is surrounding the nucleus, this is rough ER because this has ribosomes attached on it. And here you can see this suspended ER, this smooth ER. This is smooth ER because this does not have ribosomes attached on it. All right, these were the cell organelles. These are the diagrams. You can identify these diagrams. Also, these cell organelles are also quite easy. Now, in this chapter, we will also be studying the organization of life, how life is formed. We studied the basic unit of life is the cell. Cell is the basic unit of life. It has all the organelles that perform their specific functions. A group of cells, when cells have a similar function, a group of cells with similar structures, when they work together and perform a similar or shared function, they form tissues. And then these tissues, when they make a group, a structure, they make an organ. So an organ is a structure made up of a group of tissues working together to perform specific functions. So cells make tissues, tissue make organs. Organs work when they are working in a similar system, they make the organ system. So a group of organs with related functions working together to perform any body function. So you will get another idea by looking at this diagram. You can see this is a singular cell. A singular cell is the basic unit of life. It's a one cell. And when these similar cells, you see all of these cells are of similar nature. They are possibly performing the similar function as well. That's why they make a tissue. And when these tissue, a group of tissues, when they perform a similar function, they make the organ. Organs in our body are like the heart, the kidney, the lungs, all of the liver, those are the organs. Now, the heart, you can see in this diagram, it works together with the arteries and the veins and it makes the organ system. This is the circulatory system. Another example would be the digestive system. The digestive system has a lot of organs in it. It has the stomach, the intestines, and all of the other organs that are responsible for digestion as well. Next, we have some specialized cells in our body and in plant cells as well. These specialized cells don't usually have the similar structures as a typical animal or plant cell. So here we will study some of these. So here we have the type of cell, where it is found, and its function as well. So first we have the root hair cells. You see it is shaded green, so it's present in plant cell. It's mentioned here as well. It's present in plant cell. They're the root hair cells. They are found near the end of the plant roots and their function is to absorb water and the mineral salts from the soil. Next, we have the ciliated cells, which are present in animals. They are called ciliated cells because of the presence of cilia on top of these cells. They are found on the lining of the trachea and the bronchi of the lungs. And their function is to move mucus upwards. The cilia are responsible for moving the mucus upwards so that they don't get inside our lungs. And then we have the red blood cells. The red blood cells are also present in animals and all of the mammals as well. They are found in the blood of all mammals, and the function of the red blood cell is to transport oxygen. Then we have xylem vessels. Xylem vessels are specific to plants. And in plants, we have xylem vessels in their stems, in their roots, in their leaves as well. The function is to transport water. The transport water and also mineral salts, or the water and mineral salt that was absorbed by the root hair, is transported by the xylem vessels. And these xylem vessels also help in supporting the plant to keep the plant upright from the soil. Another cell that's present in plants is the palisade mesophyll cell. And this palisade mesophyll cell is beneath the epidermis of the leaf, and it is responsible in photosynthesis. When we see a typical plant cell, it is usually the palisade mesophyll cell. But we say that this is a specialized cell because of its shape. It's quite cylindrical in shape, and they are quite jumbled together. There is not much space between the palisade mesophyll layer of the cells of the plant leaf. Then we have the nerve cells, which are present in animals. They are present throughout the bodies of all animals, and their function is to transmit information in the form of electrical impulses. The nerve cells are not just present in our brain, which is a common misconception. We have them in our spinal cord and throughout our body as well. They are responsible for transmitting information in the form of the electrical impulses. Next, we have the sperm and egg cells, which are present in all animals, in their testes and ovaries, which are the reproductive organs of animals. And these sperm and egg cells are responsible in reproduction. In reproduction, they fuse together and they form a zygote, which then forms another offspring of those parent cells, parent animals. Here now we have the diagrams. These three diagrams are for the plant cell. These specialized cells are only present in plants. The root hair cells, you can see this shape. This is like a generic shape, but then you have the root hair coming out of this cell. Then you have the palisade mesophyll cell. It is very elongated and it has a very, very large vacuole in the middle. Then we have the xylem vessel, which is a large vessel which just transports the water throughout the plant. Next, we have these cells which are specific to animals. We have the red blood cell. You can see that shape is quite dented in the middle. This shape is also different from a ordinary animal cells. That is why these are specialized cells. Then we have ciliated cells. They have these cilia on top. So cilia are the finger-like projections that are coming out of these cells, and they stop the mucus, or they move the mucus upwards. Then you have the nerve cell. You can already see that this is a completely different shape to the cells we studied before. This is a nerve cell. And then we have the egg cell and the sperm cells as well, which are also specialized, which are different from ordinary cells of the entire body.